Now question number 5, 3 number simplify. You have to do the simplifications. First of all, before doing these problems, you have to observe the terms. 297 into 297 minus 203 into 203. So I can tell that numerator, it is given 297 square minus 203 square divided by 94. Okay, so 290 a square minus b square means a plus b, a minus b. So write a plus b, a is your 297 plus 203, and another will be 297 minus 203 divided by 94. 297 plus 203, how much? 500. And then 297 minus 203 will be 94. And here 94 is already there. So this 94 will get cancelled. Answer will be only 500. See how it is easy. Okay, similarly one number also, two number, three number, by observing the terms or how it is given, then you have to think which identity it will match, then that identity you have to apply, then easily you will get the answer. Okay. See the question number 6, it's little bit lengthy but it is easy. See here 1 plus x, 1 plus x square, 1 plus x power 4, 1 plus x power 8, at last 1 minus x is given. So at that time you have to check the terms. So here 1 plus x, 1 minus x, these two, for these two term I can apply the formula. So for these two term I have written together, then after these three terms I have written, see factors I have written. So a plus b, a minus b, a square minus b square, a is your 1, b is your x. So a square means 1 square, b square means x square, that means 1 minus x square. Now see 1 minus x square written, this one is already with that term. So 1 minus x square, 1 plus x square, again formula. So it will be 1 is your a and b is your x square. So again 1 square minus x square square, it will be how much? 1 minus x power 4. Beside that term already x power 1 plus x power 4 is there. For again for these two term I can apply the formula. Okay, so a minus b, a plus b. So a square means 1 square, b square means x power 4 square. So 1 square means 1, x power 4 square means x power 8. So 1 minus x power 8, here already 1 plus x power 8 is there. So now see 1 minus x power 8, 1 plus x power 8. So again a minus b, a plus b. So again apply the formula, a square minus b square. A square means 1 square, b square, b means your x power 8, b square means x power 8 power 2, that means 1 minus x power 16. So this will be your final answer. Okay, see the question number 7 is little bit, it's looking like little bit tough, but it is very easy. See here also numerator, see the numerator term, 4.359 into 4.359 minus 1.641 into 1.641. So that means it's which form term it is given, a square minus b square it is given. So a is your 4.359, b is your 1.641. So a square minus b square. So a square minus b square, I can write it as a plus b, a minus b, or a minus b, a plus b. So a, this is a, this is your b. So a minus b I have written. So this is your a, this is your b. So a minus b. So 4.359 minus 1.641, a plus b, 4.359 plus 1.641. So and denominator see already 4.359, 1.641 is given, no need to do the subtraction. See here this is given, this is given, and here it is given. So if you do the subtraction also, then also it will get cancelled. So without wasting time, simply you cut, because this numerator term and denominator term already same is given. So if you do the subtraction also, then also after doing subtraction you will get the same term. So why to waste time? So simply you can cut this one. So now you have cut. Now the remaining term is there, what remaining? Only this terms will be there, 4.359 plus 1.641. Do the addition, answer will be 6. Okay, Now, see, 3.7 into 3.7, 2.3 into 2.3 plus, observe this term, 2 into 3.7 into 2.3. See, 3.7 is square for this, 2.3 is square, 2 into 3.7 into 2.3. A square plus B square plus 2AB. Isn't it? This is your A, this is your B. So A square plus B square plus 2AB. Which formula? First identity formula. That is your A plus B whole square. A plus B whole square. Isn't it? So write A plus B whole square. A is your 3.7, B is your 2.3. Written? Okay. So 3.7 plus 2.3 is how much? 6. Already square is there, 6 is square. So in denominator, 4.6 plus 3.4 is 8, and 4.6 plus minus 3.4 is 1.2. So you have got here this one, 6 into 6 divided by 8 into 1.2. So for this 1.2, if you remove the decimal, it will be like this, 6 into 6 to 10. This denominator 10 will go to the numerator, na? Why this 10 will come here? Because if I remove this decimal here, 10 will be there. So this 10 will come to the numerator. That's why. Okay. And 8, 1, 1.2. Now it will be 12 because I have removed the decimal. 6 to the 12. 2, 3 is the 6. 2, 4 is the 8. 2, 5 is the 10. So 3 into 5, 15. Divided by 4. 15 divided by 4, it will be your answer. So I think option it is given, I think 3 1 by 4, 3 2 by 4, 3 3 by 4, like this it is given. So answer will be 3 3 by 4. A option, that is your answer. So with this, your exercise is completed for half yearly. So do practice all these exercise thoroughly, all the examples, everything you do complete, and do the revision every day, practice every day, then only you will remember the formula. Only three formulas are there. Okay, bye bye.